What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and yes, we are doing another MDT video. Technically, it's not really an MDT video. We're configuring a couple of things to get MDT working, and today is all about WDS, Windows Deployment Services, and also configuring your DHCP for your MDT server. So let's get right into it. All right, so where we left off on the last video, hopefully you guys check that out. On the last video, we actually went over the custom settings.ini section of the deployment, as well as configuring the bootstrap.ini section. Try to automate as much as you can using MDT. So today is all about installing your Windows deployment services or server, so you are able to pixie boot machines and, you know, use MDT to deploy your task sequence. Now, I already have a WDS server within my production lab. I'm going to show you guys how to do everything on another server. So this is how we do it. So on the desktop, we are going to click on the start menu. We're going to click on Server Manager. On the upper right-hand side, let's click on Manage. Click on Add Roles and Features. We're going to get the Add Roles and Features wizard. We're going to click on Next here, Next again, Next again. And then we're going to locate the Windows Deployment Services. We're going to give it a check mark. It's going to want you to add additional features. So just click on Add Features. Click Next here. Click Next. Next. I'm going to leave all the role services. The default is checked off. Just leave them alone. Click Next here. And just click Install. It's going to start installing. And it is done. Awesome. It's really simple. Now it is time for us to configure our WDS. So on the desktop, let's click on Start, and we're going to open up the Windows Administrative Tools folder. We're going to locate and click on the Windows Deployment Services. It's going to load up. We're going to expand the servers node, and you're going to see a nice little warning on your server. Don't freak out. That little warning is basically it needs to get configured. So what we're going to do is select it, right click on it, and then select configure server. You're going to get the wizard. We're going to click next here. Install option, you have either integrated with Active Directory or standalone server. This is really up to you. Pick your poison, click on next. By default, it is going to drop everything within the C drive. You are able to move it somewhere else. I'm going to leave it as a C drive, but if you leave it inside the C drive and click next, you're going to get a warning. It doesn't like to be in the C drive, in the primary drive. So you are able to continue. Just hit yes. For your Pixie server settings, this is really up to you. I like to pick response to all client computers, known and unknown, and then click next here. I'm going to uncheck add images to the server now. Uncheck that and click finish. And then we're good to go. All right, so WDS server is good to go. It is time for us to import a boot image. Now, I'm inside my production server right now, which is a different name. And I'm actually going to basically import the image of our MDT server that we have been working with, right? So from here, we're going to expand our server. Again, this is my production server. What I just showed you is how to get WDS up and running. And I'm going to select boot images. I'm going to right click on that folder. I'm going to select add boot image. And now my file location. My file location is actually the network path of my MDT server. MDT01BTNHD, that's the name of my server. Deployment share, $, again, it is hidden. And inside the deployment share, there's a folder called boot. When you update your deployment share, it creates two WIM files, a 64-bit and an 86-bit WIM file. We're going to select the 64-bit one, and we're going to click open. We're going to click next here. You're able to change the image name and a description. I typically leave everything as the default and just click next here. A nice little summary, next. It's going to start adding the image and done. Click on finish. Your image is there. Now, this is my thing. It's not really best practice, but this is something that I typically like to do when I add a new image or do anything within the WDS server. I like to reboot the server. So on the node, I like to right click on it, go to all tasks, and just restart. I just like to have this little informational dialog box to show up. Successfully restarted Windows Deployment Services. This is always a good thing. Who doesn't like to see good things pop up? Okay, so we just finished configuring our WDS server. It is time for us to configure our DHCP policies. Now, open up your DHCP, and within here, I have all my policies configured underneath the scope of 192.168.1.0. And if I go inside policies, these are all the policies. Now, how to create policies, basically, you're going to right-click on the policy folder and just click on new policy and just give it a name, description, and just follow the rest. I am going to show you my configurations for these four policies that I have, so don't freak out. So what's inside each policy? Now, the first policy is called Pixie Client UEFI 64-bit. That's the name. I gave it a description. If we go inside conditions, this is the condition for it. Let's click on edit. And this is basically what I have for that particular policy. Same way with capital P, capital X, capital E, capital C, clients, just the way you see it, this is how you have to have it. Now, the next settings, you got to go inside options and have a couple of options enabled. The first one is 60, which is your Pixie client, and the string value would be the following. The way you see it, that is the way that you have to enter it, all cap. The next one would be 66. And the string value will actually be your MDT server, okay? This right here, you need to enter your MDT server. The next option is 67, the boot file name. This value is actually inside your WDS server. Got it? Your WDS server. This is where you're getting this value from. Now, the next policy is the following, which is for 86-bit. You don't really need to do 86-bit. I don't think a lot of people are pushing out 32-bit operating systems anymore. This is the settings. This is the policy name, description. The policy name and the description is really up to you. Don't need to add what I have. It's all up to you. But what you really need is the condition. This definitely need the conditions. If you click on edit, this is what you need, the way that you see it. Now, if we go inside the options tab, again, we need to enable 60 with the following string. We need to enable 66, and the string value has to be your MDT server. 67, the boot file name would be the following. Now, for the next policy, which would be the Pixie client BIOS 86 and 64. Again, you might not be using this, but if you do, this is how you configure it. The policy name and the description, all up to you for the conditions. And let's click on edit. This is what you need for this particular policy to work correctly within your infrastructure. Let's go to options. Again, we need to enable only 66 with your MDT server IP. And we also need to enable 67 with the boot file name. Now, the last policy is default boot TP class. Again, policy name, description for the conditions. Let's click on edit, and this is what I have for that particular policy. There's no options for this particular policy, so we could close it. Now, if you go inside scope options, you're going to see all your policies kind of pre-populate right here, and then you should be good to go. Now, it's time for you to test out Pixie booting. So what you're going to do is create a virtual machine or get a laptop or a PC, get it into your network, press F12 to Pixie boot. Now, for some reason, I was trying to do it within my infrastructure, and I was getting a lot of ARP timeout. It was freaking me out. I did some Googling, and I did some testing, and apparently there is a fix for the ARP timeout, and this is how you do it. So within your WDS server, if you right-click on the server and you go inside Properties, and you go inside the TFTP tab, by default, you have Enable Variable Windows Extension enabled. So uncheck that, and we need to also head to the DHCP tab and enable configure the DHCP options to indicate that this is also a Pixie server. So give it a check mark, apply it, okay, and then try it again. Before you try it again, what I did was I actually right-clicked on the WDS server. Again, this is one of the things that I like to do all the time. I went to all tasks, and I just restarted the services and just make sure that whatever changes I made, it's successfully done, and I just like this informational dialog boxes. For me, it tells me go. Now, right now, don't go anywhere. I'm going to show you like a quick video of me Pixie booting, getting into the deployment share and all that stuff, but something happens, so check it out. All right, so you saw at the end of the video, I received an issue, and this is a known issue. So what issue is it? It is this. This is a known issue with the latest Windows ADK for Windows 11. And this is the reason why I'm starting my MDT stuff again, because this is happening. There is a fix, so stay tuned for the next video. I'm going to show you guys how to fix this problem so you have a successful Windows 11 deployment using MDT. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out. All right, bonus for this video. Hopefully you guys stayed tuned at the very end. And it's all about IP helper and configuring your switches for Pixie booting. I actually have a virtual switch, a 2960, a Cisco switch that I'm going to show you guys how to configure it using IP helper. So how to configure your switch for IP helper. So I'm going to double click on this virtual switch. I'm going to go inside the CLI. And let's open this window up a little bit like this. Awesome. Let's hit enter. Let's get in it. Hit enter. Awesome. Let's give it the password. If I remember the password. Oh my God. Do I remember the password? Awesome. Hit enter here. I have the caps lock on. Oof. All right. Cool. We're in. Let's do an enable. Let's get in the password. Boom. From here. I'm going to do a show run config, hit enter. So I have everything already configured. I have a VLAN. My VLAN is not set up with the IP helper. Now the IP helper will be your DHCP server. So we need to set up our VLAN 10 with the IP helper IP address, which will be your DHCP server. So how would you do that? So let's get out of here. We're going to do a config T. To get into configuration mode. And I got my cheat sheet right here. Got my little black book, you know, got to have your little black book right here. We're going to do an interface. We're going to get into our VLAN. For me, it would be VLAN 10. And it's super simple. We're going to do an IP helper. Hopefully I can spell right. There we go. And it would be the IP address of your DHCP server. And all you got to do is just hit enter. That's it. We're going to exit out of that. We're going to exit out of that again. We're going to hit enter a couple times. We're going to do a copy run config at startup. And then we hit enter, enter again, and we're good to go. We're going to do another show run config. And if we go all the way to the bottom in the section where it says our VLAN, where is our VLAN right here? We have our IP helper address, which again, your IP helper address will be your DHCP server. And that's it. Hopefully you guys stay tuned at the very end and got this quick little extra bit. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.